yesterday I put out the part one for kind of the first time going over kanji, and this is the part two. So yesterday we went over five different ones. It was the five different of the radicals, the human legs, ten mouth, and one. So there are four more that I have, or more that I actually kind of learned about, so I know at least like a little bit about it. But we'll get started. So person's reading a book to tell a story. Okay, so this next one I actually know fairly well. This one. that means plan. So again, I can't really think of a way to really tie it in or remember that one, but it's plan. It's got a little, got the word radical and then just a little cross beside of it. Okay, so that was the last one for the word radical. The next one is the I forget which one they have it. It's either the sun radical or the day radical. I mean the kanji for it means the same thing, like sun or day, but I forget which one they said it was in the video. This right side's like it's got a whole bunch of stuff going on there, so I don't think I would be able to. I think it would take me a while to actually be able to memorize that one. Maybe not. I mean, if I'm learning about time specifically in like different times, I might pick up on it pretty quick. But I'd have to use it over and over again. This one right here, that one means like projection or reflection. So the way that they were in the video that they were I guess describing on how to remember it is this little character on the right. You kind of see it as like a little person, and one on the left, you know, meaning sun, it could be like reflecting down on like water, or you could just see it as like a little mirror. The guy is looking at his reflection. Interesting about it is it right here. So that's a movement radical, but by itself actually doesn't mean anything. It's always attached to something, and I think it's always in the bottom location. I know at the very least for these next three, it's in the bottom part. So kind of like with the human legs, kind of was supporting it. This one, I'm supposed to have something to do with, I guess, like movement when you put it with other kanji. So let's see. Really know how the movement radical plays in here, to be honest. But this one right here, that means weak. So like to see it. I mean, I don't know. You know, if, I guess, you know, with the gate, if you think the gate has, like, a, I guess, like, a division, it could be, like, a division of time, you know, if you look at the sun having something to do with time. So this last one right here means to listen. Again, I don't think I have anything I'd really be able to use to memorize this one. This one's a little funky. Actually, I kind of want to look at the stroke order on how to write that little piece in there, because it's like, I mean, the way that I do it, at least right now, is I'll do that like top line and that right hand line, and then I'll do that like bottom diagonal, do that left line, and then the two horizontal lines. But it's really that kind of slanted line at the bottom that throws me off. I don't know, that's just me. So, that is the end of the nine different kanji between yesterday's and today's video. So yesterday had the human radical, the human legs radical, the ten radical, mouth radical, the one or the horizontal line radical, and then today the word radical, the sun radical, movement radical, and the gate radical. So that's just 9 out of 220, either exactly or about.